Sports. It's in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. Here's a scene a short time ago. The Ravens introduced to this sellout crowd, and through a sea of pyrotechnics, out they came from the tunnel. We're set to go as the Ravens get ready to match up with the Las Vegas Raiders. Here's the former Auburn kicker, Daniel Carlson, to get this one started. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium.
And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25.
First and 10, it's Jackson, flush to his right. Now he'll pull it down. Jackson hit, and he lost the football. And the Raiders pick it up.
Not only a fumble loss there, but a fumble lost on your first drive in your own territory.
Now you're dealing with a lot of stuff here because you feel bad going off the field because you gave up the football. How does your own defense feel now having to go out there and stop them when the momentum has clearly shifted in their favor?
Opening minute, and already a trip to the red zone. They've got a first and 10 at the 15. So after the fumble recovery, it's Carr. They'll roll him out right. And that is caught. It's Ruggs. Touchdown, Vegas.
Complete to number 11.
Henry Ruggs. There to make the grab. And the Raiders have taken the early lead.
Well, that's how you take advantage of an early turnover. A sudden change situation, meaning ball's turned over. How's both sides going to handle it? One side handled it way better. They went right out on the field and put the ball in the end zone.
One play, that just added insult to injury.
Yeah, that just tells you on the defensive side, they didn't come out ready to go, still reeling from the fact that the ball got turned over.
And this carries into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
Let me breathe for a minute, man. Just let me breathe for a minute.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
They're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 22 yards there, a first down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Trying to get it to Willie Snead there. And that'll bring up second down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful. Throwing into too much double coverage might have a couple of them picked off. Jackson's throw on target to Willie Snead. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 43. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 43. And Jackson throwing once more. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Dez Bryant, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. Throwing again. Jackson. He gets this underneath to Dobbins. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. The last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. Steps away to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Now on fourth and inches, they're going to want to talk this over. We get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So they'll say no to the 50-yard field goal try. Instead, the offense out there, they're going for it. Being chased out left. He may try and run for this. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. That's complete to his running back, J.K. Dobbins. Jackson. No gain on the screen there, it's second down.
J.K. Dobbins. No gain on the play. Brings up second and...
Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson. They set up the screen for Dobbins. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16.
That's good.
It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line.
Jackson on first down, buying time to his left. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
J.K. Dobbins, the one he was looking for.
And it's second down.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Quick slant to Brown. He's down inside the 10 to the 8. And it comes on a gain of 8. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. From 8 yards out, and the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and we are tied at 7.
Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone.
And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
24-yard line.
Set to get this drive started. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Darren Waller, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And this one is incomplete. Nelson Agholor, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
Well, so far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Third down throw incomplete as well.
Intended for Henry Ruggs. Incomplete. That is three plays and out. It's fourth down.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth down with Carr. The connection here with Nelson Agholor. And unable to break away, they stop him a few yards shy. A surprising move to go for, and predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. Steps away. And that one is incomplete. And it also concludes quarter number one.
The end of the first quarter with the score tied 7-7.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 as they line up, second and 10. To throw again, Jackson, and he's got his man in stride, complete.
Jackson's pass.
5 yards, now it's third and 5. They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a third and 5. And that'll be complete to Dobbins. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 6-yard line.
They'll run with Dobbins. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Down here near the goal line, you don't think of a cornerback in run coverage, but he made the stop.
Yeah, most of the cornerbacks we know, they want to be those pass defenders and take away one half of the field. But the best ones in the game are the complete corner.
And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. A 6-yard touchdown run, and the Ravens have taken the lead.
Justin,
people always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Damn.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get...
The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit. That's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
And he's going to go down. He sacked back at the 24. It's the former number 4 overall pick, Cleland Furl, that got in there to bring him down. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson forced out to his left. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. He got outside the pocket there trying to improvise, and he was calling for the ball downfield, but still the interception.
I think what happened, he did call for the ball thinking that he was open, but I think the quarterback spotted him too late, and that margin that he had on the defenders, that got eaten up, and they came up with the interception.
Now after the INT, it's Carr. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. But when this ball's tipped and intercepted, it's Chuck Clark picking it off. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open.
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
This pass into the arms of Snead. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Dobbins running out of the gun. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7.
It's a pickup of 3.
Bring from the gun, Jackson. Flushed out right. Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. On third down, Jackson escaping the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. They're going for it with Dobbins. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1. Just a gain of 3, but they'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half as the Ravens push further out in front. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and he's going to get 2. That's great. But from the 15, the risk-reward, it's just not there.
So risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you
you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we were having a tough patch, this too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally, we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. Carl, try it again on second down. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Working from the gun, it's Carr. He'll find his running back. It's Jalen Richard. And he is going to have the Raiders' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The pickup goes for 16 and a Raider first down. Carr to throw again. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. 19 on the last play, 19 more here, and another first down. Again, it's Carr. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
And the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. It's caught, Jones. And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. Into the red zone, it's Carr. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Carr again here on second and 10. Flush to his right. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. J.K. Dobbins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Ravens will extend their lead. The one play, 80 yards. Pretty easy drive to recap.
It certainly is, but not so easy to execute. Starting on your own 20, you want something to kickstart your drive and get it off to a nice start. They went for the whole thing and got it. That's a great way to send a message to the opposing team.
Ravens 26, Raiders 7.
So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back.
And the ball is knocked out, and it's picked up by the Raiders. But they will not be able to capitalize as time has run out here on the first half of play. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. The Raiders are going to have it first, and they trail here as we get back to it in this third quarter of action. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now Carr. He'll let this go deep for Ruggs. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
Brings up second.
A shotgun snap and a give to Dobbins. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third and four coming up.
Loss of a yard on the play. It's now third
Jackson.
And four.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And nearly a touchdown as they finally stop him down at about the 3-yard line. They needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying,
and he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Raiders take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12.
Makes the score Ravens 26, Raiders 14. Daniel Carlson to kick off for Las Vegas.
Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. This will make it into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line set to get going. Their lead down to two scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10. Eluding and a big loss here as he's taken down. Max Crosby able to get in there and run him down for what's going to be a loss of 15 yards all told. Off the play fake to Dobbins, here's Jackson. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first?
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Now Jackson. Throw right side taken in by the tight end, Bryant. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
It's a gain of five. Brings up second and five.
From the gun, it's Jackson. Caught by Snead over the middle. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 44-yard line.
To throw again is Jackson. Bryant with a catch right side. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 43 yards that time.
That is the exact right play call against that defense. So a hat tip to the offensive play caller because he won that part of the chess match. But give credit to his players as well. They won the execution part of it.
this one down to about the 10-yard line. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
A gain of a yard brings up second and nine.
Stepping up, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Lamar Jackson keeping it himself from 10 yards away, and the Ravens will add on to their lead.
Well, that was all Lamar Jackson all the time on that drive, both through the air and in the end with the touchdown run.
Yeah, how about him doing things a little bit on the reverse side there, Brandon, because he softened him up throwing the football and opened up the running lanes. And when he gets a little bit of a sliver, he's gone. And that's exactly what he did there.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Sacked by Yannick Ngakoue, the former Maryland Terp. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. Another try after the first down sack. Carr, catch is made by Hunter Renfrow. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the gun, it's Carr. And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. And it's picked up by the Ravens. And they will have the football deep in enemy territory.